We are beginning tonight with the many new developments surrounding last week's attack on Giants fan Bryan Stow of Scotts Valley, beaten and nearly killed at a Dodgers game last Thursday night. Today, family members spoke publicly for the first time since the attack. We will hear from them in just a moment. But first, the latest on Bryan Stow's condition and recovery. Today, his doctor said Stow is showing signs of having some brain damage. We also learned that after Thursday's attack, doctors had to perform what they are calling a life-saving operation, during which they removed the left side of his skull in order to relieve pressure on Bryan's swelling brain. Doctors say there is brain damage, but at this point, they just don't know how much.
It's going to be a long recovery process either way. And right now, we're still trying to make sure that he's stable and he's out of the critical period where he's still at risk of having worsening brain injury.
Dr. Azada says, contrary to reports not long after the attack, they did not have to remove the frontal lobe of Bryan's brain. They did, though, as we said, temporarily remove a portion of his skull to relieve pressure. As for long-term effects, doctors say Bryan's injuries will most likely impact memory and personality.
We are also learning more about the investigation into the attack on Stow, including a significant piece of information that was previously unreported. It turns out that Stow was not the first Giants fan attacked in the parking lot of Thursday night's game. Police announced today several other Giants fans were also attacked in the parking lot. None of them were hurt, but those attacks happened not far from where Stow was ambushed and just a few minutes beforehand.
There's several leads. We are receiving a lot of tips from the public. We don't know any specific area we're targeting, but we are looking at everything closely, and hopefully the information we're receiving will identify the two individuals responsible for this senseless attack. There's no place for this in baseball.
These are the sketches of the two men that police believe are responsible and may be responsible for other attacks. A reward for any information that leads to an arrest doubled again today. It's now up to $100,000. Then there is Stow's family speaking publicly at today's press conference.
Now, just imagine how you might feel if a member of your family was attacked in such a fashion. Anger, rage. Well, the Stow family today was remarkably forgiving.
On behalf of Bryan and his family, friends, we want to express our extreme gratitude to Dr. Zada and the staff here at LACUSC Medical's American Medical Response and all of their employees who have been so amazing. And we can't put into words how much they have done that means that what it means to us. Thank you to the LAPD for the exhaustive efforts and their professional dedication. Thank you to the Marriott of downtown for their generosity and the San Francisco Giants for reaching out to Bryan in this time of need. Our family and friends would also like to thank everyone around the nation for their support and prayers of Bryan. To know that people who have never met Bryan could care so much about him and his well-being has truly been overwhelming. Though this has been a terrible tragedy done by cowardly people, it is reassuring to know that good people are speaking out and are appalled. We would like to use this as a rallying cry to stop unnecessary violence in our greatest pastime and all other sports, not only here but abroad. This would be one of the greatest gifts you could give to us, and especially Bryan. So I ask for one last thing on behalf of Bryan, that we all enjoy a safe and competitive and exciting year of baseball and a successful Giants home opening weekend at AT&T Park. Thank you.